G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest from Infinite Wealth and today we are talking the top 5 Perth hotspots for 2022. Now before we get into it, if you want to find out how we help our clients quickly build an asset base that pays them $2,000 a week or more in passive income, pays their home off up to 3 times faster and saves them thousands in tax every year, then simply click the link on offer. Now, Perth has maintained a level of performance throughout 2021 and has ended the year with 65% of suburbs classified as rising markets. That's one of the strongest results in the nation. The 116 suburbs classified as rising markets is the second highest number in the 6 years hotspotting has been conducting its quarterly surveys of sales activity. And in the surveys from 2015 through to the end of 2020, the average number of rising suburbs in Perth was only 29. Now, the 4 surveys conducted in 2021 have all revealed over 100 suburbs with rising sales momentum. Now, this means the Perth market is at its strongest since the end of the resources investment boom in 2013, and this is reflected in both the numbers of locations with rising sales activity and in price growth outcomes. Now, analysis of the locations with the best results shows that the greatest strength in the Perth market is at the bottom end. So most of the strongest precincts are affordable outer ring areas. And the number one standout is the city of Wanneroo in the far north. Now, of its 21 suburbs, 20 are categorised as rising markets and the other is rated as a consistency market. Now, suburbs with strong quarterly sales growth patterns include Alkimos, Clarkson and Wanneroo. Most of the other affordable growth markets are in the south. In the Gosnells local governmental area, all 8 suburbs are classified as rising markets, including the suburb of Gosnells and Maddington. Now, there are 6 suburbs in the local governmental area of Kwinana, the cheapest precinct in the Perth metro area, and all of them are growth markets, including Parmelia and Wellard. In nearby Rockingham, 7 of the 9 suburbs are rising markets. They include Baldarvis, where the quarterly sales over the past 18 months have been almost tripled, and Port Kennedy, with similar growth in activity. Now, 5 of the 7 suburbs in the Armidale local governmental area are rising markets. And in the east of the Perth metro area, 6 of the 7 suburbs in the Swan local governmental area are upwardly mobile markets, with the standout being Allenbrook. Now, when it comes to the city's middle markets, the standout performers are the local governmental areas, of Stirling and Cockburn. In Stirling, which always features in these reports, there are 23 suburbs in our report. 14 of them are rising markets and 4 others are rated as consistency markets. Now, if we look also in the city of Cockburn, 10 of the 13 suburbs have rising sales activity. Conversely, 2 municipalities, which often feature prominently, that being the city of Melville and the city of Joondalup, are surprisingly lukewarm with their results. In the city of Melville, only 5 of the 14 suburbs are rising markets, while in the city of Joondalup, only 6 of the 18 suburbs have maintained upward momentum. Prices are growing right across the Perth area, but not at the same rates as elsewhere in Australia. As an example of the 177 suburbs included in our price analysis, all but 2 had annual growth in their median house prices, with 155 of them rising more than 5%. But only 18 of them increased by 20% or more, which is well below levels seen in other capital cities and in many regional markets across Australia. The level of value uplift being experienced in the Perth market would be considered notable in normal times, but currently, and compared against the rest of the country, it's underperforming. Now, there are no major clusters of suburbs with exceptional growth in house prices, but there are individual performers across the city. Of course, many of the best are at the affordable end of the market. Now, the number one suburb for growth is Ascot in the Belmont local governmental area, where the median house price has risen by 37% to $795,000. Medina in the affordable Kwinana local governmental area has grown 33% to $265,000, while nearby Orillia is up 18% to $280,000, and Wellard has risen 20% to $415,000. In the city of Wanneroo in the far north, Girraween, Yanchep, Marangaroo, and Queen's Rocks have all had good growth, mostly places with median prices below $450,000. Now, in the far south, Armidale has risen 28% to $255,000, and Kelmscott is up 23% to $350,000. Maddington in the Gosnells local governmental area has lifted 20% to $330,000, and that gives you an update on how things have been performing. But now, it's time to get in to our top 5 Perth hotspots for 2022. Starting us off at number 5 in our top 5 hotspots for 2022 is the city of Cockburn. The fortunes of Cockburn are strengthening as billions are being spent on transport infrastructure, retail, residential, commercial, and defence projects. The city of Cockburn's transformation from its industrial roots to a vibrant residential region is evolving through the rezoning of large tracts of land. And this local governmental area is proactively courting population growth and is attracting first home buyers in droves. Now, the state government is supporting the urbanisation by spending $3.6 billion on improved rail services to the southern suburbs of Perth. Now, this includes three new train stations which will better connect residents of Cockburn with Fremantle, the Perth CBD, and Perth Airport, making it easier for residents to commute, whether it be for work or leisure. Now, the state government's development body Land Corp is redeveloping North Coogee over 15 to 20 years to create 5,000 homes, while Port Coogee Marina is being upgraded with extra berths and new commercial and retail precincts. Meanwhile, the Defence Force is spending a massive $183 billion on shipbuilding. The Cockburn property market has multiple suburbs with strong rising sales activity. And when coupled with tight vacancy rates, all of these below 1%, at least 10 suburbs with house prices below $550,000 and numerous job creating projects, the city of Cockburn provides plenty of opportunities for home buyers and investors. Next, at number four in our top five hotspots for 2022 is the city of Stirling. Now, the city of Stirling property market is rising, and that's on the back of several large infrastructure projects. Now, the Stirling City Centre project is touted as being one of Australia's biggest urban regeneration projects, while $1.6 billion is being spent on upgrading two of the LGA's major shopping centres. Another $400 million is being spent on various transport projects as three levels of government work towards transforming the Stirling City Centre into a Metronet-style hub. Now, this is accompanied by falling vacancy rates, increasing rents, and government incentives, which have also encouraged more first home buyers to enter the market. The results are a positive effect on the Stirling property market, where most suburbs are experiencing rising sales activity and prices. Now, the city of Stirling offers a leisurely seaside lifestyle while being home to the internationally renowned Scarborough Beach. Trendy bars and cafes impart a youthful vibrancy, attracting a steady stream of 20 to 40 year olds. Now, further adding to the region's appeal are the shopping and education facilities coupled with good transport links to the Perth CBD. Now, the Kwinana precinct comes in at number three on our top five Perth hotspots for 2022. So West Australia's economy forged ahead in 2020 and 2021, fueled by population growth, a rising resources sector, and effective management of the pandemic. And the Perth property market, named as Australia's most affordable by the Real Estate Institute of Australia, has risen on the back of that growing economy. This, coupled with the availability of government grants from both the state and federal government levels, drove the residential construction industry, especially in areas such as the Kwinana Precinct. Now, the Kwinana Precinct has as much to offer for home buyers and investors, its standout features being affordability, good yields, low vacancies, and population growth. Indeed, this is the cheapest precinct in the Perth metro area, with some suburbs having median house prices below $300,000. It also has access to key job nodes, train links to the city, access to nearby beaches and green space like the Spectacles wetlands. Kwinana is part of the massive Western Trade Coast industrial area, which provides employment for 11,000 people, and it is constantly expanding and creating more jobs. Now, these factors, complemented by the largest lithium plant in the world, which began production 2 years ago in 2019. Getting down to our top two now, and coming in second at our top five Perth hotspots for 2022 is the city of Wanneroo. So the Perth property market rebounded strongly in 2020 and the first half of 2021, with the municipality of Wanneroo at the forefront of a marked uplift in sales activity. With an ample supply of residential land, Wanneroo is attracting young home buyers spurred on by various government grants and incentives. Alkimos, Banksia Grove, and Yanchep have been consistently listed in the top 20 Perth locations for first home buyer grants in the past 5 years. Another positive aspect of the Wanneroo property market is the tight vacancy rates, which have been falling steadily since 2017. They are now well below 1%, a position not seen since the end of the previous mining boom in 2013. And over the past decade, 177,000 new residents have moved to this municipality, making it the fastest growing local governmental area in Western Australia. There's little sign of a slowdown in the growth of this region. And in support of this growth, both the Mitchell Freeway and the Joondalup to Butler train lines are being extended, while the state government is building new schools. Growing industrial areas are providing employment opportunities, and with houses in many suburbs priced in the $300,000 and $400,000 marks, properties in the city of Wanneroo are worthy of attention by both home buyers and investors. All right, guys, while we are here, time for our number one, the top spot for our top five Perth hotspots for 2022 is the Rockingham local governmental area. The Perth property market has transformed from recovery in 2020 to boom in 2021, with a doubling, I should say, in the number of suburbs with rising markets. Amid this activity, the suburbs of Rockingham City feature strongly. The availability of numerous government incentives for first home buyers is giving the Perth property market momentum, a factor highlighted across the affordable Rockingham City market, where sales activity is heating up. The suburb of Baldivis has been ranked regularly in the top two positions for first home buyer grants over the last decade. With population growth driven by an attractive seaside lifestyle, tracts of affordable land, and access to major job nodes, this local governmental area is a community of young families. Residential construction, fueled by strong population growth, is expected to continue well into the 2040s to satisfy increasing demand. The revival in this precinct is supported by some of the lowest vacancy rates in the Perth metropolitan area also. So guys, that rounds out our top five Perth hotspots for 2022. Just a reminder, if you want to find out how we help our clients quickly build an asset base that pays them $2,000 a week or more in passive income, pays their home off up to three times faster, and saves them thousands in tax every year, then simply click the link on offer. Have a great week, and guys, remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks a lot, and bye for now.